Hey guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to replace the speedometer cable in a 924, early 944, and a 924S. So over time these cables will wear out and begin to make your speedometer needle bounce around a little bit. And in other cases they'll completely snap in two and then your speedometer doesn't work at all. If you have any of these issues, then it's probably time to go ahead and replace your cable. And I'm going to be showing you how to do that. But before we start, I'm going to take you down the road and show you what this car is doing here. So as you can see, this speedometer cable is causing the needle to bounce around, so this is why I'm going to be swapping it out for another one.
Alright, before we get started, I thought I'd show you some of the tools you're going to need. First of all, you're going to need a 24mm socket to remove the steering wheel nut.
Once you have the steering wheel off, you're going to need to remove the cover that goes around the windshield wiper stalk and the turn signal stalk. And in order to do that, you're going to need a small Phillips head like this. Then you're going to need to remove the stalks themselves, so you'll need a flathead screwdriver like this one. Then we'll be removing the gauge cluster and you'll need a larger Phillips like this one. Once that's done, you're going to need to raise up the driver's side of the car, so you're going to need a jack and a 19mm socket. Once you have the wheel off, then you'll be scraping off some RTV and removing a clip from the end of the cable, and you'll need your flathead screwdriver again. And before everything goes back together, you'll need to scrape off all that RTV, so you'll need a razor blade. So the first thing I need to do is remove this gauge cluster so that way I can get in behind the speedometer. But in order to do that, I need to remove the steering wheel and this column here. So first I'm going to start by removing the horn pad. And you want to be careful because there is a wire on the back side of the pad that's for the horn. And if you pull too hard, you'd end up breaking it. I'm just going to set that aside. Next, you'll need a 24mm socket that's going to go on this nut down here. And you may need to lock the steering wheel. And you want to make sure that you do it with the handle towards the outside, because if you do it inside, you could end up smacking your windshield. Broken free, you should be able to easily remove the nut and the washer. So once you have the nut removed from the steering wheel, you're going to want to take your key here and straighten your wheel back up like that. And so when you remove the wheel, you'll know exactly where it goes back on. Next, I'll remove these stalks, and first I'm going to go ahead and remove this cover down here. There are two screws holding it on. Once you have those out, then this cover just comes right off. You want to be careful break it. And then to remove the stalks, you'll need a flathead screwdriver. And then you'll remove these three screws here. Once you have the three screws out, then you'll just push up on this and the stalks will pull forward and you'll be able to unplug them. Then you can lay those to the side, and then you're going to remove this upper cover here, and it'll pull out just like that. Again, you want to be careful here because there are two tabs and you don't want to break those off. Once you get to this point, you're almost ready to remove the cluster. All you need to do now is remove two Phillips head screws. Once those are out, then you can just pull the cluster out. Once you have the cluster out, you're going to find the speedometer cable right down here, and it's simply going to unscrew from the back of the speedometer. Sorry, I've got a spare speedometer and a cable here. It's very difficult for me to get the camera behind the cluster to show you how everything's connected, so I thought I'd show you like this. Now, you can see here that this is the bottom of the speedometer, and if I turn it around, you can see how the cable goes down and off to the side. This makes it very difficult to reinstall this cable with the speedometer in place, so it's easier to just go ahead and pull the entire cluster. So once you have the cluster pulled, then all you'll need to do is unscrew the cable like this and pull it out. So here's the cable that I'm going to be removing. Now I need to jack the car up and take the front wheel off. So removing the cluster is actually the hardest part, and you can see here that the cable comes through the firewall and then runs down to the front driver's side wheel here. So as I mentioned, I need to jack this up, get this wheel off, and then you're going to find the other end of the cable clipped to the hub. So once you have the wheel off, you're going to find where the cable connects to the hub, and if it's the first time being replaced, then you're going to find it underneath some RTV, so you're going to need to remove that with a flathead screwdriver, and then you'll see the cable and the clip. Once you have enough of that RTV removed, you're going to see the end of the cable and the clip that's on the end of it. And you'll just push the clip off. As you can see, it's just an ordinary E-clip. And if you happen to lose it, then they are available at most hardware stores. And you want to put that somewhere safe so that way you don't lose it. Once the clip is removed, then you can just take the cable from behind here and pull it out like that. And there you go. So now you'll just have the cable hanging here, and what you'll need to do is push it on out through that hole there, and then come up to the engine bay, and you're going to see it go down there and just hold up here. Once you have it like this, then you can just go around inside and pull it out. So, alright, I have a brand new cable here. So, alright, I have the cable out of the bag now, and here's the recommended installation instructions. It says always lubricate the interior of the sleeves on both sides using standard ball bearing grease before installing. Never kink or pinch the shaft or pull it over edges or corners. Always lay it straight or in large loops. That's a lot of ors in that sentence. Do not exceed the bend radius of the GMO packaging. This serves as a guide. Fix connections to speedometer and transmission or wheel hub and lightly insert them. Do not pinch, crush, or handle with tools. So I'm going to do the first part here. I have some ball bearing grease, and I'm going to go ahead and just lightly lubricate the inside of the sleeves here. Alright, once you have the speedometer cable unpacked, you're going to run it exactly how you pulled the other one out. So you're going to take it and run it straight through here, and you're going to find a hole on the firewall and push it through. installing the cable, make sure you take your time and don't bend it up too much. It needs to go around this metal plate here, and then you're going to find the hole up there. You're going to push it through.
Once you have it started, you can go ahead and carefully pull it on through. Once you have the cable pulled into the engine bay like this, then you're going to go inside and connect this end to the back of the speedometer and start putting everything back together inside here. So alright, I'm going to take my cable here and I'm going to connect it to the back of the speedometer. You will gently need to push on the cable, and it's going to push it out towards the engine bay. That's why you don't want to connect it to the hub right yet. And once you have your cluster installed, then you're going to install your top plate here. And you're going to take your stalks and plug those in first. Then you're going to install your three screws. Tighten them down too much where you can strip the threads. Next, you'll put your bottom plate on. Once everything's back together, you're ready to install your steering wheel. This one's going to go on just like that. Take your washer, put it on, and then you'll take your nut and run it down. You're going to take a 24 millimeter socket and tighten the nut down. Once you have the nut tightened down, then you'll go ahead and install the horn pad. Don't forget the wire that goes on the back there. And everything inside is now done. All I need to do now is install the other end of the cable to the hub. Once you have everything put back together inside, then you're going to go around to the engine bay here, grab your end of the cable, and run it down through this grommet here. And you should find it down here, and then you're going to run it through this hole. So now you should have the cable like this, and what I'm going to do now is go ahead and clean the rest of this RTV off the hub here, and once I get it removed, then I'll be ready to push the cable through. Alright, I now have this RTV removed, and you want to make sure that you keep it out of this hole here. You don't want that getting down into your bearings. So next I'll be pushing the cable through, and on the back side here next to the caliper, you're going to find a hole that you're going to push it through. Have it pushed through, you should see the end of the cable here. You may need to turn the hub until everything lines up. Once it does, you should be able to push it on through like that there. If it doesn't go the first time, then you may just need to back up a little bit and then try it again, and it'll pop through. Next, we'll install our E-clip.
like that. Once that's done, you can take some black RTV and reapply it like the factory had it on there. And this will help keep any dirt or dust from getting down in the wheel bearing. And you're just gonna let that sit for a while. All right, I let this sit for about an hour, so I'm gonna go ahead and put the wheel back on now. Now that I have the wheel back on, let's go for a drive. All right, so as you can see, the new cable has fixed the issue and the needle is no longer bouncing around. So all right guys, that's how you install a new speedometer cable in your car. If you like this video, be sure to like and subscribe. I upload videos like this every week. Also come join us on Facebook. I'll put a link in the description below. I also want to thank everyone who supports me on Patreon. These videos wouldn't be possible without you. But anyway guys, that's going to do it for this video. So we'll see you next time.